안녕하세요, 여러분. 안디도 나 naman tayo for another episode of my Korean cooking show. Charot. We're just here to learn more about Korean food and to learn how to make it and to learn about the history and the culture that goes with that particular food. So today, dahil mainit dito sa Korea, it's very hot, but at the same time, sumasabay din sa kanila ang rainy season. They call the rainy season actually Jangma. So Jangma, it's rainy season. So as of today, umuulan siya. Since yesterday, and dahil maulan, syempre gusto mo ng mainit na sabaw, ganyan. So perfect yung gagawin kong food for today. So I'm going to be making a one pot dish that's called Bosot Takbeksuk. So, bosot means mushrooms, and then Takbeksuk. So it's tak is chicken. So I'm going to be using a whole chicken, and then beksuk is that's meat that is cooked without marinade. So yan tinatawag na bosot takbeksuk. So it's mushroom, whole chicken, and with mushroom soup. Yan ang gagawin natin today. So this dish is very similar to another dish that's more popular, which is called samgyetang. So for those of you don't know, samgyetang is also a one pot dish. It's also a whole chicken dish. But the difference with takbeksuk is that samgyetang has more components, versus a takbeksuk. The takbeksuk, basic takbeksuk, will only have leeks, garlic, and then the whole chicken. Basta tatanggalan ng taba sa leeg, taba sa puwet, and yung end parts ng wings. Kasi nga, if you don't remove that, nagiging super oily yung soup. Tsaka man. And then, yung samgyetang naman, it has ginseng, it has dates, it has a lot of yung mga kung ano-anong branches na galing sa kung anong halaman. And then it has, what is that? Okay, so yun ang difference sila. And the samgyetang has sticky rice inside the cavity of the chicken. So, habang niluluto siya, naluluto din yung malagkaning malagkit dun sa loob ng manok. So, when you serve it in a clay pot individually. Ideally, individually. They use really small chickens naman. So talagang parang pang isang tao lang. But for the recipe that I'm going to be doing today, I'm going to use a bigger chicken. Gagamit ako ng mas malaking manok para, you know, it's a family meal. And I'm not going to be putting sticky rice inside kasi nga takbeks yung gagawin ko. Although, naglagay ako ng, naglagay ako ng ginseng kasi nga, my husband has been, you know, tired lately kasi nga mahaba trabaho. Mahaba yung time na sinispend sa work, and he works in a kitchen. So, it's a physically tiring job. So, naglagay ako, you know, pampa-energize, ganyan. So, Koreans eat this kind of food during the summer kasi nga madaling mapagod sa summer, and they call this kinds of food, they call it boyangshik. Boyangshik. Boyang means recovery, and shik comes from the word umshik. So it's a recovery food. So literally translate, it's called recovery food. So yan ang tinatawag nating takbeksuk. So this is only a version also of takbeksuk. Maraming ibang version. It's really up to you how do you want to make your own version. But for us, this is one of our level up versions of takbeksuk. And yeah, so it's best eaten with, I'm going to put chives. Naglagay ako ng chives. I just blanched it in chicken broth para hindi siya na overcook. And instead of wrapping your chicken meat in lettuce, you wrap your chicken meat, or you eat it with the blanched chives. Ganun siya kinakain dito sa Korea. And, you know, it's really healthy. Sa Pilipinas, you can eat it. You can just make beksuk using leeks and garlic. Pero, in the Korean store, you can find yung may mga packs na sila na binibenta na pang samgyetang. So, yung laman nun, there are may dates, may kung anong roots ng kung anong halaman. And then, may kahoy, ganyan. So, they use that when cooking takbeksuk also. They just put it with the chicken and they boil it. So, meron dyan sa Korean stores. You just ask the ladies or the owners for that, yung ginagamit sa samgyetang or sa takbeksuk. So anyway, I hope you enjoy this video, and always, as always, always stay safe, practice social distancing, and hope to see you soon. Annyeong! Don't.